In this screencast, I'll demonstrate how to calculate the enthalpy that occurs before, during, and after a phase change. Let's start by looking at a phase diagram, in particular, that of water. Let's see what happens when we go from a liquid at 50 degrees C to a vapor at 150 degrees C at constant pressure, in this case, one atmosphere. So the first thing we do is we raise the temperature from 50 degrees until we hit the boiling point, or 100 degrees C. Then as we change the phase from liquid to vapor, we put in heat, but the temperature and pressure stay the same. That's because all the heat is going into changing the phase. Now, when the water is all vapor, the temperature rises again as heat is continued to be put in until we reach 150 degrees C. So let's see how we can calculate that. So what we're going to look at here is an evaporator. And we have right here liquid water, and 1 mole per second is going in at 50 degrees C. In the evaporator, it is heated and vaporized, and we have H2O vapor that comes out at 150 degrees C. And this process will take place at a constant pressure of one atmosphere. In order for this to occur, we actually have three steps. So step one is that we heat the liquid water from 50 degrees C to the boiling point, which is 100 degrees C. And the reason we heat it to the boiling point to calculate the enthalpies is because that's where the heat of vaporization is measured. This step here, when heat is being put in to change temperature, is what's known as sensible heat. The second step is the phase change. And this is where all the liquid water vaporizes until we only have water vapor left. And this is what's known as latent heat. And while this is occurring, there is no change in temperature or pressure. Finally, step three is we're going to heat the H2O vapor from 100 degrees C to its final 150 degrees C. And this is also sensible heat. So let's start by step one. And in order to find the sensible heat, we use what's known as the heat capacity. And this is often called C sub P. And this is defined as the amount of heat needed to raise the temperature of a substance by a certain amount. The way we find the sensible heat is to integrate this heat capacity from our starting temperature, in this case 50 degrees C, to our boiling temperature, and we integrate the heat capacity of liquid water, which is in this case 75.4 times 10 to the minus 3 kilojoules per mole degree Celsius. And so when we calculate this, and we're going to call this our H1, it equals 3.765 kilojoules per mole. That's the enthalpy of our first step. Our second step is that phase change, and for that we use the heat of vaporization that's looked up at 100 degrees C, and that's equal to 40.656 kilojoules per mole, and we're going to call this H2. Our third step also involves sensible heat so that we use a heat capacity. However, we're going to have to take the integral from 100 degrees C to 150 degrees C. And now we're going to have to use the heat capacity of the vapor, which is slightly more complicated than that of the liquid. And when we calculate this, it will equal 1.722 kilojoules per mole. Often, to simplify things, we truncate after the first term. And if we had done that instead, we would have ended up with 1.673 kilojoules per mole. Finally, we add them all up to get our final enthalpy. Why can we add up all of these enthalpies? Because enthalpy is what's known as a state function. All we care about is the initial and the final state of the enthalpy. We don't care what path we went through to get there. And so even if this physically is not what's happening in the system, we can put together hypothetical paths that we know the enthalpies for and calculate the difference in enthalpy. So let's add these all up. And this entire thing is multiplied by 1 mole per second. And when we do that, we end up with 46.1 kilojoules per second, or 46.1 kilowatts. One thing to notice when we're calculating this enthalpy is how much of the energy is caused by the latent heat or heat of vaporization. So when you're calculating an energy balance that has a phase change in it, it's essential that you add that latent heat to get the correct answer.